base, the Golgi base, x exponent. And what are requirements for A? Is it any number or not?
Any real numbers, including irrational numbers.
Yes, but some restriction.
Yes.
What restrictions?
I can't remember, sorry.
Can it be less than zero?
No, it has to, A has to always be greater than zero or equal.
Greater than zero. That's, and what else?
Equal
A
also.
Than zero and A.
Oh, it cannot equal one.
One, not equal one. Otherwise you have constant. Yes, A not equal one. This is a restriction for A. And all, yes, all real number except negative, zero and one, all other numbers. Okay, and what is X? What is domain? Domain.
Let's see. A is the exponent. I mean the base. So in that case, X would be the exponent.
Yes. And as any restriction for X, what numbers? Where function defined?
I can't think of it. I'm sorry.
X domain. For what value of X function is defined?
Value of X?
Is it all X's, all real X's? Yes, it is all real X's. X can be any number. A, we have some restriction, but for X, no restrictions. It is all real numbers. Negative infinity. Positive infinity. That's what's X, negative infinity, positive infinity. That's domain are all the real axes. And what about range? Y. What value of Y?
Range the Y value that's left after X?
Is it all real numbers or not?
Yes.
It has to be greater than zero.
It is not equal zero, and can it be negative?
No,
it is greater than zero. Why is greater than zero?
Hi everybody, Harris here with the iGuide.
It cannot be negative. It is only greater than zero.
And once you're in tab,
so now we can
to pick up something for you. This will prevent you from ever forgetting about that again. So in order to schedule text for a certain day and time, we're just going to use the shortcuts. So go ahead and go into shortcuts on your iPhone. And once you're in shortcuts, you're going to go down to the automation tab. And from there, create a new personal automation. And then you're going to do time of the day.
Only positive.
Or time of day. So we'll pick a time.
Because the horizontal asymptote x-axis.
Okay.
The approach
you're going
to
want to do
but never
because it needs to reset. So you'll set this for monthly, and then you'll have to delete.
And what is Y intercept?
One downside. So, okay, we'll say January 28th.
I write Y intercept.
Right, so then for the action, it comes up by default with send message. Otherwise, you might have to search for send.
What is Y intercept?
Downside. So reset.
X equals zero. Substitute. Y intercept is
and once you're in shortcuts, you're going to go down to the automation tab, and from there, create a new personal a automation.
A to the zero. How many?
And then you're going to
one.
Do time of the
one. For any A to the zero,
so we'll
equal
time,
one.
Say that's midnight. Correct.
So all right. Graphs pass okay. On this
and then
point.
You're
going
to want
one.
To do monthly because it needs to reset. So you'll set this for monthly and then you'll have to delete it after. That's like kind of the one downside. So, okay, we'll say January 28th and we'll click next. All right, so then for the action, it comes up by default with send message. Otherwise, you might have to search for send message there. And we'll do click. And then you put the message there. So the basic example is happy birthday, but this could also be remember to pick up the dog.
And this function grow very, very fast.
Things. I remember to pick up a package.
It
remember to
grow
the milk,
faster than
to,
any polynomial
finish
functions.
Your homework.
Any power
anything, right? So we'll just say remember it's
very fast growth. Exponential growth.
Pickles.
Okay. Do we have to do the midterm review for homework?
Recipients. Unfortunately, you can't do a group chat
here. No homework
awesome,
for.
But you can do multiple people. So I'll
next.
Say Apple.
But we have homework number 6 today.
Well.
We'll discuss it.
What's up, guys? We'll click done. And
that's what we know.
So
about
you can do text, you can also
function.
Do clipboard. It doesn't
and
look like you can send.
No, for
a photo.
Example,
maybe you can get
we can
this
take
and
this
send a photo.
FX
I'm not too sure. But anyway, click next.
To the X. 0 for 1, it will be 2. For 2, it will be 4. And so on. Mm-hmm. 2. And what is the graph of 2 minus x? We see that fx is increasing when x approaches to infinity, y approaches to infinity very fast. And if exponent is negative. What does it mean? How can we clear off negative exponent? We change the base 1/2 to the x. If base is less than 1/2, like this. It's the same as 1/2x. 1 to the x is 1 over. Well, we can see that this will be reflection to x-axis. Symmetrical with respect to y-axis. This function will be decreasing. When x approaches to infinity, function approaches to zero. Positive infinity, it approaches to zero. And for this function, it approaches to zero when x approaches to negative infinity. Okay. If x is negative, we get 2 to the x. If x is positive, we get like this, 1/2 to the x. Okay. And what is exponential function with natural base? Natural base e. What is e? Natural. Base E, what does it mean, base E? What number it is?
Isn't that 1?
No, it is lim and approach to infinity. 1 plus 1/n to the n. That's what exact definition, and this is e approximate. It is irrational number, infinite, not repeating decimal, approximately equal 2.718 28, and so on, infinite, not repeating decimal. Okay. E. And so function will be, it's very similar, base a little bit different. Fx equal Ex. The graph is similar. And for this function, the rate of change equal to the function. Rate of change equal e to the x. And does this exponential function has inverse or not? How to find whether function has inverse or not? What is the test for inverse function? What test check? Do we have inverse or not?
The horizontal line test.
Very good. Esther?
Yes.
Very good. The horizontal line test. Well, we see any horizontal line intersect the graph only once. So it has inverse. And how do we call inverse for? What function is inverse to? Exponential. No, we keep the same base, A. How do we call inverse to exponential function? What function is inverse to exponential? No, I will draw the graph. The graph of inverse function is symmetrical with respect to line y equal x. Symmetrical means that any point we draw perpendicular to the line of symmetry and continue this by the same distance, and the point will be on the graph of inverse function. How do we call inverse to exponential? Esther, how do we call this function? Somebody hear me?
Yes, inverse to exponential, that would be a logarithm.
Logarithm.
And that would be y equals ax.
Uh-huh. We write log ax. Base is the same requirement, greater than zero and not equal one. X and y. Y is exponent, a is base. Base log, it is exponent, and the result will be, we can rewrite in exponential form x equal a to the y. Okay, that's what is logarithm. Logarithm is exponent. We needed to erase base to get x. And what can we say about domain and range of logarithmic function? What does that mean? What is the relation between domain and range on function and its inverse? We know domain and range of exponential function. Domain is all real axis. Range is positive. Y is greater than zero, only positive. And what about domain and range of inverse function?
Let's see. Y, as you wrote, law is log 2x.
Mm-hmm. No, first of all, what about domain? Domain?
Will be x equals 2y.
X. Domain, it is x. What can we say about x?
There's positive real numbers.
Positive real numbers. Excellent. X greater than zero. Because range of exponential function was y greater than zero. Now, for inverse function, domain is range of inverse. For exponential range was greater than zero. Now domain x is greater than zero. Domain and range change places. Domain became range and range became domain. Range of exponential is a positive real numbers. And now domain will be positive. That's what we need to memorize. Negative numbers don't have logarithms. Logarithms are defined only for positive numbers. Okay. Logarithm undefined for negative numbers and for zero. It is undefined only for positive numbers. So sometimes if we get solution of equation which are negative or zero, we say no solution, because for negative numbers, logarithmic function is undefined. Okay, and what about range? What about range of logarithmic function?
The range is a set of real numbers as well.
All real numbers, okay. Because range is the same as domain of exponential. For exponential, domain is all real x's. Now range is all real y's. We write range, y, negative infinity, positive infinity, all real numbers. Oh, that's okay, it doesn't. Positive infinity. Okay, and now we can graph these numbers. And now y-axis is asymptoted because x is not in domain. So when x approach to zero, we say function approach to negative infinity. It increase from negative infinity. It got when x is one. What is logarithm? For zero, it is undefined. What is logarithm of one? The graph pass through point 1, 0. Because any number to the zero equal one. So logarithm of one is zero. Any all logarithmic functions with any basis pass through point x intercept 1, 0. Exponential function pass through point 0, 1. Now symmetrical to it is 1, 0. And then it, when x approach to infinity, function approach to infinity. But very, very slowly. Logarithm is the most slowest of all functions that approach to infinity when x approach to infinity. Increasing function, but slowly, very slowly. Square root grow faster. Square root grow faster than logarithmic. No linear function y equal x also grow faster. Then we have polynomial function x square, x cube, and the fastest, the most fastest grow, it is exponential. That's the rate of change. And how do we call logarithm if base is e? Logarithmic function with base e.
Ln.
Ln, very good. Log, I will write log e x equal ln x. We don't write any base, we write ln. Unfortunately, many people made this terrible mistake. Instead of L, small L. Unfortunately, when we print, when we type, small L look like one, like I, well, ln. It is the same, but some people write I, capital I, I-N. It is nonsense. What is it? Make no sense. They understand this as ln, but it is absolutely wrong. I say it each session, but many people made this mistake, not only in homeworks, but even in tests. Please be attentive. Don't write like this. Ln you can write, but it is better to write like log L. Ln, that's how we should write, natural logarithm. It means logarithm with base e. Ln means the base equal e. It is inverse to e to the x. Inverse f minus one will be ln x. Write L like small rhythm L. It is not first, it's like Roman. Some people write like Roman digit one. No, it's not good. It looks like they copy from some and don't understand what they would. No, this is logarithmic, it is L, ln. And there is another log which then don't write base. It is log with base 10. Log 10. Sometimes they write 10, but sometimes no base. If we write log x, it means that base equal 10. In our calculator, we cannot have all possible bases. We have only two bases. Log 10 in calculator, log. Log means that base equal 10. And ln, it means that base equal e. So in calculator, usually we have two functions, log ln. But if we need exponential function, we press second or shift, and the calculator gives us exponential function. We can take ln x, no, for example, ln 2. It gives us number 0.693. And it is infinitesimal. Usually we can restrict by three digits, ln. But if we want exponential function, we press second, ln, and it gives us e to the power. Now, for example, e squared. 7, 3, 8, 9. So calculator give us tens logarithms with base 10 and logarithms with base e. But how to find logarithms for any base? We can do it. Well, first of all, we see the graph of logarithm. We see that both graphs symmetrical with respect to line y equal x. For exponential function, we have y-intercept, but we don't have x-intercept because x-axis is horizontal asymptote. It approach to x-axis, but never touch it. So, and vertical and y-intercept equal 0, 1. Vertical asymptote we don't have. And logarithmic function, on the contrary, it has only vertical asymptote. Vertical asymptote is y-axis, because for x equals 0, function is undefined. It approach to negative infinity, and it has x-intercept. It doesn't have y-intercept, because for x equals 0, it is undefined. But x-intercept for all logarithmic functions is 1, 0. X equals 1, y equals 0. That's what we have. One vertical asymptote and x-intercept. And for x approach to infinity function, approach to infinity very slowly. It is the slowest of all increasing functions. So to find logarithms with base 10 or base e, we can use calculator. And so for, well, calculator can be different. Some calculators have exponential function, but most calculator doesn't have exponential function. To find exponential function, we should press second or shift L, N, or L. And how to find logarithmic function for any base?
Just enter log of the base in the calculator?
Yes, but calculator give us only two bases, natural e and 10. And if I want, for example, I want log 2, of 5. How can I find it using calculator? Now I can write, this is y. I can write 2 to the y equal 5. Both equations are equivalent. This is logarithmic form. This is exponential form. It is the same equation. I can rewrite logarithmic equation into exponential form and exponential equation into logarithmic form. Well, I can, what is 2? 2 can be expressed using natural logarithms. For example, I can write 2 equal E ln 2. And so 5 can be written with the same base, E ln 5. So according to definition, because logarithm is exponent needed to erase base to get the number 5. And so I can rewrite this, replace 2 and 5 by expression, exponential expression using base e. It will be for 2, I will write e y or ln 2 times y. It is product, it is not ln 2, one function, and y another, equal e ln 5. And there are the properties of logarithm. As function is one to one, it means that if bases are the same, the results, the expressions are the same, it means that exponents are the same. We see the same basis, EE, equal, the numbers, the results are equal. It means that exponents are also equal. Rewrite, we get y ln 2 equal ln 5. And so y is logarithm, is logarithm 2 to the 5 of 5 equal ln 5 over ln 2. That's it. We call this a formula change of base. Now we can find this. We, in our calculator, we have natural logarithms. And we take logarithms of number we need and divide by logarithm of base. And the same formula is true if we use logarithm with base 10. We can write log 5 equal log 5, we mean base 10, log 2, the same. And for any base, we can write general formula. We can write log base a x equal ln x over ln a, or 10 log base 10 5 divided by log 10a. And this is true for any base. If we want to transfer from one base to another, we can write log a x equal log b x, another base, divided by log b, the same base of a. That's it. This is a formula change of base. And we can write the properties. What properties of logarithmic function? Well, first of all, for any base, logarithm of 1 equals 0. What is log for base a of a? How many it is? Log a, a.
One?
One, of course, by what exponent we should erase a to get a? One, yes. Very good. Joe, very good. Log ax a, log a, ax equal
x.
X, very good, it is according to definition. To get ax from a, we should erase into exponent. And next, that's what we already use, number 4, states that if logs are equal, the numbers are equal with the same base, like ax equal log a Why? If and only if, it means that this is true in both directions, if and only if. It's if log, if the x, y equal, logarithm for the same base are also equal. And if and only if x equal y. And if x equal y, then log r equals. Well, these properties are clear. And now we will consider the same properties are for natural logarithms. The same, I will write. Ln 1 equals 0. Ln e equals 1. Ln e to the x equals x. And ln x equals ln y. If and only if x equals y. And if x equals y, logarithms for the same basis are also equal. Mm-hmm. So logarithmic equation can be expanded or condensed using the properties of logarithm. Oh, I think everybody knows this. What is our properties? What is the log of product? UV. Logarithm of product. What is it?
What does that say?
What is the logarithm of product of two variables? We know law of exponents. We know that when we multiply, we add exponents. Now, inverse function, logarithm. If we take logarithm of product, what operation we do with each? What operation correspond to multiplication? When we multiply, we add exponent. Now, inverse, when we take logarithm of product, we add exponent. Logarithm of product equals sum of logarithms for the same base. Sum of logarithms. What is logarithm of quotient? Quotient. Who knows what is logarithm of quotient? Well, you know, when we divide, we subtract exponent. Now inverse function, quotient, it is difference of logarithms with the same base, minus okay. And what is the logarithm of power. When we erase of power, what we do? Those exponents A U to the N. When we erase into power, what happened with logarithms? We multiply if it's product N log. So exponent can be written in front of logarithm. Equal N. No, and the same properties have natural logarithms, exactly the same. Now, for example, let us write ln square root of 3x minus 5 divided by 7. This is expression. How can we expand this expression using the properties?
Ln of radical 3x minus 5 minus ln of 7?
Yes, first of all, we can write this as difference. That's correct. Very good. Okay, and what else? Now we can use the property, the third property, because square root, it is exponent 1/2 fraction. We can write 1/2 ln 3x minus 5 in parentheses, minus ln 7. That's good. That's how we expand. No, let us write log 5 x cube y. Log means that the base is 10. How can we expand this? Use the same properties. It is a product. We can break it into sum of logarithms. 5 plus x cubed, it will be 3 log. And plus log y. Now, and we can, sometimes we need to condense logarithmic expression. Now, for example, let our expression is 1/2 log x plus 3 log x plus 1. How can we condense this? Write as log, as 1 log, log. What expression we write? No, first of all, it should be product. Then we take exponent, we take factor as exponent. X 1/2, it is square root of X multiplied by x plus 1 cube. That's what how the contents. Sometimes we need to solve exponential and logarithmic equations. Well, and we use properties 1-to-1. That, for example, if logarithms are equal, then the expression also are equal. And in opposite direction, expressions are equal, then logarithms are equal, if and only if. And we can write inverse properties of inverse, because logarithmic form and exponential form are equivalent. Sometimes to solve, we need to rewrite logarithmic equation into exponential form, or on the contrary, we rewrite exponential form into logarithmic form. Well, now we will. We will do some specific examples. e to the x equal 72. Let us take logarithm of both sides, ln e x equal ln 72. What is the left side? Ln of e to the x. What is it?
Ln of x?
X, it is x. According to definition, it is x. Well, we can do it formally. We can write x in front, then we write ln e. And we know that ln e, it is 1. So it is x equal ln 72. And this we can find using calculator. It is approximately right wave, because it is not exact value, 4277. You can check, take your calculator and find ln 72. That's almost first example. Second example. For example, 3 to the x equal 42. Well, first of all, divide by 3 both sides. You get 2 to the x equal 14. Now we can take log of 2x. Log 2 equal log 2, the same base of 14. No, 2 and 2, this is 1. We get x equal log 2 of 14. And we can use change of base formula, ln 14 divided by ln 2. And we find x equal approximately 1807.
Why did you do ln?
You can take, because in our calculator we have only ln and log 10. You can take log 10 if you like it more, doesn't matter. You can make sure that the answer will be the same.
What if you did log 14 over log 2?
That works.
Of course, I don't have a log with base 2. In my calculator, I have only two bases. Base natural E and base 10. And base 2 I don't have. But I know the formula, the change of base. I can find log with any base using this formula. No, ln is easier. Let us make sure. You don't believe me. Oh, very good. Let us take, I take my calculator. I take ln 40. I take 2639. Right. Equal 2639. Now I take ln 2. ln Well, we can do it directly. Like, do this 2x equal 14. Let us take ln. It will be x ln 2 equal ln 14. It's the same thing. X equal ln 14 divided by ln 2. And final answer is different. Six, nine, three. 3808, that's correct. Uh-huh. 3808. Oh, we can leave the answer in logarithmic form. It's not mandatory to write numerical answer. You can write ln 14 divided by ln 2. That's correct answer. You can use 10, logarithm 10. You will see that it is the same. Take log 14. One forty-six divided by log 2. Log 2. 0301. One 46 divided by 0301. You get the same 3 8. No small difference due to rounding. 3.807. If we don't round, we keep everything in calculator, then we will get exact value. Mm-hmm. One more example. X plus 5 equals 60. EFC, e to the x equal 55. Take ln, it will be x ln equals ln 55. Well, we do elementary operation, algebraic operation before, and then use one-to-one property or inverse property. Вот оно. Ну, вот это вот он сейчас попадает куда-то. Ну, все, больше не работает. Ну, шучу. О, ну, теперь она сдвинулась на ответ. Ага, нет, теперь на печку. Помню, тут оно. Что-то должно быть какое-то радикальное. Это безопасно. Я вообще не вижу. Так она вообще исчезла. О, пошла. Сейчас мы ее поймаем. Все. Тут пошла. Ой, собака. Ага. Так, мы вернули это. Сейчас мы возьмем крыло. Ой, господи, боже мой, где же мне ее держать так, чтобы она никуда не упадала? Так. Опять она куда-то попадает. Угу. That's another example. X minus 5. So here 2x minus 5 minus 4 equal 11. Ну, first of all, we do elementary operations. We got 2, 3, 2x minus 5 equal 15. Divide by 2, we got 3, 2x minus 5 equals 7.5. Mm-hmm. I will take ln. This will be exponent. We write it first. 2x minus 5 ln 3 equal. You can take any logarithm. Ln, no, 15 over 2. X minus 5 equal 7.5 divided by ln 3. Mm-hmm. Ну, and divide by 2. 5 over 2 plus 1 over 2. And the ratio of ln 7.5 divided by ln 2. That's Now we consider quadratic equation, logarithmic equation, exponential equation, solving as quadratic. It will be e to x minus 3 e x plus 2 equals 0. Ну, we can see that if we take EX as a new variable, then we will have quadratic equation. We can write EX square minus 3 E to the X plus 2 equals 0. This can be factored. This can be factored. It will be E to the x minus 2 and e to the x minus 1. The sum equal negative 3, the product equal plus 2. And so we get e, let each equal 0, minus 2 equals 0. E x minus 1 equals 0. E x equal 2. E x equal 1. Ну, E x equal 2, we can take logarithm. X ln e equal ln 2. Ln is 1, x equal ln 2. And here x ln e equal ln 1. Ln 1 is 0. X equals 0. So two solutions. Now we consider example when there are extremes. In general, when we solve logarithmic equation, we should check substitute in original equation to make sure that our solution is in domain. Log five x plus log x plus 1, x minus 1, minus 1, equal to. Well, first of all, now we condense log 5x, x minus 1. Equal to. As no base means that base is 10. We can write 5x, x minus 1 equal 10 square, equal 100. 5 x square minus 5x minus 100 equals 0. X square minus x minus 20 equals 0. This can be factored. X plus 5, x minus 5. X plus 4. The product equal negative 20, the sum equal negative 1, equals 0. So we have two solutions of quadratic equation. X equal 5 and X equal negative 4. But second solution is not in domain, because if we substitute, we get log negative 20. It is undefined. So domain of this is x greater than 1. And negative 4 is less. So x minus 4, we write reject. We can write reject. Not in domain. But x equal 5 is solution. It is in domain. Five, 25, 4, that's his domain, okay. We can check. Seven. It is 1, 3, 9, 7. Log 4. Yes, check, I substitute, I get 2. That's correct. Original equation is satisfied. That's what we should do. Substitute in original equation. So now only one solution. X equals 5. X equals negative 4 is not in domain. That's it. Now we will discuss homework 6. I will check who is it. Oh, I will take attendance. Okay. You are here. Hitchcock, Kagan. You will help me. Okay. It was homework number 6. You did it. Elliot Caitlin. I don't see her. Emmanuel here.
Here.
Michael Karasik. Michael. David here. Ilya. Few people today. Today we have a review. Not good. Ilya, not here. Sarah, few people. Nicole here.
I'm here, Professor.
Joseph, you have points today. Yes. You have a situation. Very cool.
Thank you.
Jose here. I don't know. And Esther also has points. Okay. That's it. Maybe they will come later. We will check. Okay. Homework number 6. This is easy. Usually these problems in midpoint, midterm, everybody do 100%. We got page 233. Number 7. Вот это нельзя делать. Нельзя писать ту кусту. Number 7. For log 4x base 4x. For to the x equals 16. How we do this?
So you do 4
all divided by 16. I mean 16 divided by 4.
We can make the same base, correct? What is 16?
It's 4 squared.
4 squared. Very good. Very good. Okay. And so we use a 1-to-1 property. Because this is equal, base are the same, it will x equal to. This is easy. Okay, x equal to. This is the solution. Number 8.
X equals minus 5.
Mm-hmm. Minus 5, very good. 1 over 2x equals 32. We can write like, we can make the same base, 31 over 2x. It is equal 1 over 2 minus 5. Negative exponent, we get 2 to the 5. Okay, now we see the same base, so x equal minus 5. Very good. Very good. Okay, what is next? Number 9. Again, I pay attention. Never write number 9. Unfortunately, in homework, some people write IL. What is it? Nobody knows. It makes no sense. It is not IN. It is LN. Be attention. Don't write this in test. I don't know how it happened. Maybe some people copy and don't understand what they copy. LN X. We understand that this is natural logarithm, LN minus. Equals 0.
So you do ln x over 2 equals 0?
Well, it's just ln 2. And if ln are equal, base are the same, so x equal 2. This is easy. Okay. Number 15. It's number 9. Number 15. Log 4x. Now x is an expression, not the base, not exponent. Now log x equals 3. Log is given. How to do it? What should we do? What is x? X equal
250, I got.
Rewrite in exponential form. X equal. What is base? Right base 4. What is exponent?
X.
No. 3. 3. Log. Exponent is log. 4, 3. And x is the result. 4 cubed, how many is 4 cubed? 4 times 4 times 4, correct? 4 times 4 times 4, how many? How many is 4 cubed?
64.
64, that's it. This is the answer. X equals 64. It's number 19. EX equal EX squared minus 2. Well, if this is one-to-one property, base is the same, results is the same, so exponents are the same.
So X equals 1?
No, we simply rewrite that exponents are equal, x squared minus 2. Now we need to solve quadratic equation. X squared minus x minus 2 equals 0. Well, we can solve it by factoring. This equation can be factored. The product equal negative 2, the sum equal negative 1. What solution we have? What are two solutions of this equation? Each factor equals 0, we get x equal 2, x equal negative 1. What? Now, can we substitute in original equation? Yes, we can. Now both solutions are correct. Negative solution can be incorrect if we have logarithmic equation, but now it is exponential. We can substitute both solutions in original equation. Substitute x equal to what we get. E square equal E, 2 square is 4 minus 2 square, equal, true. Substitute negative 1. E minus 1 equal E minus 1 square is positive 1 minus 2 equal negative 1, correct, both correct. Both solutions are good. Because it is not logarithmic, it is exponential. Now negative solutions are good because domain of exponential function, all real axes. Number 25. 3, 2x equal 80. We can do using log 3, or we can use ln, because we have ln in our calculator, we can write. How can we do it? How you did this?
So I did ln 3 2x equals ln 80.
Very good. This is bad. Very good. First step we take ln. What we do next?
Then I do 2x ln 3 equals ln 80.
Very good. We use a property of logarithms. Okay, well now we can solve x equal 2 ln 3. Okay, that's it. We can stop. We don't need to find numerical solution. This is a solution. Number series. Ah, 7, it is 7. 7 minus 2 EX equal 5. Subtract 7.
So I got minus 2 EX equals minus 2.
Yes.
And then divide both sides by minus 2.
Very good.
You get EX equals 1.
Yes. EX equals 1. What is X?
X equals 0.
Very good. That's it. X equals 0. Into the 0 for 1. That's it. Number 37. Okay. How we do this?
I did ln 3x equals ln 2x minus 1.
Very good. Okay. What is next step?
And I did x ln 3 equals x minus 1 ln 2. And then x equals ln 2 divided by ln 3 minus ln 2.
And then we remove parentheses. Minus. Then we write x. And we found the X. Okay, or we can rewrite without minus. We can rewrite this equal ln 2, and here ln 2 minus ln 3. ln 2 over 3. Okay. X is negative, but that's okay because this is exponential equation. X can be negative. This is the answer. Что такое?
Ай.
Вот уже. Окей, ну повторю вам. На вот этот квадратик. И ту x минус 4 и x минус 5 equals 0. Well, this is quadratic equation and variable is ex. How can we do it?
So the first thing I did was factor it.
We can
so factor. You get ex minus 5 and ex plus 1 equals 0.
Very good. Okay. Negative 5, negative 4. No, and so we have two solutions, EX
equals. So EX minus 5 equals 0, and EX plus 1 equals 0.
Yes, EX equal negative 1. So what is X? We'll take ln.
So X equals ln 5.
Yes, x equal ln 5. And what about this? We can take the same x, ln e, equal ln minus 1. This exists or not?
No.
No. Because we know that negative numbers doesn't have logarithm. This is undefined, so this is, x is undefined. We can write x undefined. That's correct, undefined. Not in that way. Three minus 4 ln x equal 11. How we do this?
So we do minus 4 ln x equals 11 minus 3?
Yes, 11 minus 3. Very good. 11 minus 3. No, it is 8.
Which is 8.
Equal 8.
Then you divide each side by minus 4?
Yes. Equal negative 2.
Negative 2.
What is x?
X is 1 over E2. Now?
X equal E. E, basis E, negative 2. That's good, that's good. It is 1 over E square. This is a real number, this is defined. 1 over E square. Number 55. Ln x minus ln x minus 1 equal 2. Well, first of all, we can convex ln x
over x plus 1 equals 2.
Equal 2.
Shouldn't it be x plus 1?
X plus 1. Yes, you are right. X plus 1. And we can write
e squared equals x over x plus 1. Then you cross multiply and you get x equals e squared x plus 1.
X plus 1.
Then
multiply what we get e squared. X e square plus e square equal x. And so we get x equal e square.
E square x plus e squared.
1 minus e square. We can calculate, but we can see that this number is negative.
So there's no solution.
And so it is 55. It is not in domain because initial original equation is logarithmic equation. Domain should be greater than negative 1. But our solution is negative. It is less. Now we can calculate 1 minus e square. How many? E square is positive. 1 minus x square, e square is negative. It should be greater than 0 because ln x is undefined. So for this solution, original equation is undefined. E square is positive. E square is greater than 1. So denominator is negative. So x is negative. It is not in domain. So we write no solutions. No solutions. Because original equation is logarithmic. So x should be greater than 0. Number 57. X plus 5 equal. Minus 1 plus X plus 1. over here, minus. No, we can condense this. This
we can make it ln x plus 5 equals ln x minus 1 over x plus 1.
Mm-hmm. Plus 1. Mm-hmm. And we write x plus 5. Very good. Equal x minus 1, x plus 1. So multiply, clear of denominator, we get x squared plus 6x plus 5 equal x minus 1. X squared plus 5x plus 6 equals 0. It can be factored. X plus 2, x plus 6. What about solution? What solutions we have? What were the solutions of quadratic equation?
Quadratic equation. X equals minus 2 and minus 3?
Yes. Minus 2 and x equal minus 3. And what about original equation?
There's no solution.
No solution. Because domain of this is x greater than 1. And we have both negative. So it's clear that first is defined because plus 5, but second is undefined. X minus 1 is undefined. X plus 1 is undefined. So no solutions. Very good. No solutions. No solutions. Because these solutions are out of domain. Number 59. Luck. Three x plus 4 equal log x minus 10. Well, this we use one-to-one rule. Base are the same, expressions are the same. We can write, say, x plus 4 equal x minus 2. This is linear equation. 2x equal
14. Negative 14.
X equal.
Negative 7.
What is the solution?
There is none.
No solution. Because x plus 10 is defined, but x minus 10 is undefined. Yes, negative. And here we get negative 21 plus 4. Yes, negative. No solution again. No solution. Okay. And number 61 is the last. Equal log 4 x minus log 4 x minus 1 equal 1 over 2. Okay, how would we do this?
So we do log 4 x over x minus 1 equals, yes, 1 over 2.
We condense, very good. Mm-hmm. And we write x over x minus 1 equal 4, 1 over 2. No, 1 over 2 is square root. Square root of 4 is 2. That's it. Now we can solve x equal 2.
X minus 2.
Minus 2. And so x equal to x equal to x minus 2. Yes, minus x equal minus 2. X equal to. Okay, that's it. Now we have solution. X equal 2 is good because 2 minus 1 is 1. It is 0. Log 4 of 1 is 0. And log 4 of 2 is 1 over 2. True. We can substitute an original equation and get 2. That's it. Very good. Very good. You solve all the problems correct. Very good. Okay, now we will do review.
Professor, is the test going to be like the midterm review?
Yes, midterm review. Yes, review for midterm. That's everybody should download. Okay. Maybe some appear. Карасик Майкл, you are here, I see you.
Yeah.
Дэвид, you come. Вот. Дэвид is here. Who is it? Сара. Эстер here. Okay. Come on to the presentation today. It's very cool. Кейли Эллиот.
Yeah, hi, my phone had died. Sorry, I'm here though.
Yes, you come a little bit late. Okay. Karasik, that's it. Who is absent? Sara is absent. Okay. One student, only one student.
Professor, you got me in the attendance? David?
David, I mark you. Okay, you come. Ilya absent, and Sara, two students. Okay. Ilya Sacharkov, no. And Sara, no. Okay. Now we will do. Okay. Okay. Now we consider, first of all, domain number one. Find domain and reach. F 4 minus 6. What is the mean?
X cannot be 4.
X cannot be 4, but besides, yes, because if X equal 4, we get division by 0. But what else?
X can't be negative.
Expression under radical should be greater than 0. We can write 4 over X, 4 minus X, greater than 0. And so X less than 4. X less than 4, not equal. Less than 4. That's the main. What about range? What values of Y?
Y cannot be 0?
Yes, it is. Y can by cannot be 0 because denominator cannot be no approach to infinity. But so 0 is a horizontal asymptote. It's approach to 0. Y is greater than 0 because square root is positive. 1 is positive. Square root is also positive. So the ratio y greater than 0. This is our range. X less than 4, y greater than 0. That's correct. Now we got gx. It is rational function. X plus 4, x plus 2. X minus 1. The same question. What is domain?
X cannot be 1.
Yes, X not equal 1. Very good. Who answer?
Emmanuel.
Manner. Very good. Okay. X not equal 1. This is domain. What is range?
Y cannot be 1.
Excellent. You too. Why not equal 1? Because when X approach to infinity, Y approach to 1. So Y not equal to 1. So we have a vertical asymptote. No, we will not write it. They don't ask, but we know that vertical asymptote X equal 1 and horizontal asymptote Y equal 1. That's good. Mm-hmm. Now we need to sketch the graph of the function and we can state what transformation we do, what our parent function, and what transformation we do with parent function to get our function fx equals 3 square root x plus 2. Plus 4. Okay. Now, first of all, what is parent function? What is a parent function? When we do the graph, label axis, x, y. Origin 0, 0. Make same spaces 1, 2, 3. The same spaces. Some people don't write any numbers at all. Some people calculate too many tables with too many values. We don't need it. We only need sketch. Okay. Asymptote, if any. Intercepts, if any. What is the parent function of this?
Y equals radical x.
Very good. This will be parent function. radical, square root of x. Okay, and what transformation we do? When we add something to x, what transformation?
We push the graph up 4 units vertically.
No, first of all, we shift horizontally. Where we shift, to the left or to the right?
Left.
Left. Very good. -2. That's my point. -2. This will be my function. But then what I do? I stretch. The order is important because if I shift vertically first and then stretch, it will be another function. But now I multiply by 3 first. Instead of 1, I will get 3. Instead of 2, I will get much more, times 3, like this. And plus 4, add 4. My 0 will be in 4. This will be my function. That's okay. Stretch. So we do 3 transformation. We do a horizontal shift, 2 units to the left. We do vertical stretch, multiply by 3, number greater than 1. And then we do vertical shift, plus 4. We mark 4. Our 0 became 4. And 1 will be 7, because we multiply, when we 1, we multiply by 3. 5, 7, no, approximately this, correct. That's it. This only stretch. We don't need many points. Okay. Mm-hmm. What is next? Next, gx. Two x plus 3 cubed minus 2. Well, first of all, what is parent function? What is parent function? Так, Emmanuel, I want you participate. Very good. Mm-hmm. The answering questions is very important for the grade.
Uh-huh. Is it x cubed?
Yes, very good. What's your name? Esther?
Ooh. Esther, yeah.
Uh-huh. Okay, good. Right answer. Uh-huh. Very good. Okay. Mm-hmm. It is x cubed. We know x cubed, it is like this. What transformation we do with the function? Where we move it? Horizontally. In what direction we move?
Left, 3 units.
Left, -3, very good. Our 0 will be now in -3. We can draw vertical line, like our new y-axis, -3. And what we do else? We stretch, multiply by 2. Instead of 1, we will get 2. This will be our first point. Second point will be 2 cubed. It will be 8. Mm-hmm. 16, very fast. Mm-hmm. But, and besides we stretch, where we move, vertical stretch. What is vertical stretch? minus 2. Where we move. What is vertical stretch? Who can say? This is easy. Look at function. Minus 2. Vertical stretch, we move down. 2 units down. 3 units to the left. Horizontal stretch and 2 units down. This will be our graph. We do 3 transformation. Horizontal shift to the left, stretch, vertical stretch, and vertical shift down, minus 2. You see the direction of shift for vertical shift, it has the same sign. Positive, we move up, negative, we move down. But for horizontal shift, the shift is opposite. If plus, we move to the left. If minus, we move to the right. That's what we need to know. Okay, very good. That's it. And we need to graph, sketch the graph. Don't do tables, only show the transformation. Show parent function and the final. Parent function can be graphed by dashed line and final by solid line. Number 3, it is straight line. It is easy. That's everybody know. What is it? Point 1, 3 and line 2x plus 3y equals 6. Number 3, line 2x plus 3y equals 6 and point 1, 3. And we need to graph, first of all, we write the equation of line parallel to the given line and passing through the given point and perpendicular to the given line and passing through the given point. And we should graph all 3 lines on the same graph. What we do first of all? Equation is given. To write the equation of parallel perpendicular, we should know the slope. How to find the slope? What should we do to find the slope?
Solve for y.
Solve for y. We solve for y. 3y equal minus 2x plus 6. Y equal minus 2 over 3x plus 2. That's what we do. What is the slope? What is the slope?
Negative 2 over 2.
Very good. Esther and who? Emmanuel, the same people, only the same people answer. I want more people answer. Slope equal negative 2 over 3. Okay. Okay. And what do we know about slope of parallel lines? If 2 lines are parallel, what do we know about their slope?
slope is the same.
It's the same. M2 equal M1. Yes, because the same direction. Slope defines the direction. Parallel line has the same direction. That's okay. Now we write the equation. No, I will write y minus y1 equal m. X minus x1. We have some point. This is x1, this is y1. X is first, y is second. Right? Y minus 3 equal minus 2 over 3 x minus 1. That's it. Now we transform to slope y-intercept form. Remove parentheses. Plus 2. And plus 3. No, 3, how many 3? It is 9 over 3, correct? And 2 over 3 plus 11 over 3. Mm-hmm. It's a little bit more than 3. Almost 4. Okay. Now let us write the equation of perpendicular line. If line are perpendicular, what do we know about the slopes?
They're opposite?
Reciprocal.
Opposite signs, that's correct. And what else? Only opposite signs or something else?
Reciprocal.
Negative reciprocal, yes. Very good. It is negative reciprocal, minus and one over, that's correct. Well, because directions opposite parallel line. If one line has positive slope, perpendicular line will have negative slope. Mm-hmm. And the value is negative reciprocal. So for our, it will be equal positive. It will be 3 over 2. And we will use the same formula. Y minus 3 equal 3 over 2. X minus 1. And X minus 3 over 2 plus 3 plus 3. No, it is 6 over 2 minus 3 over 2. It will be Y equals 3 over 2 X plus 3 over 2. That's it. Now we will graph all three lines. I hope everybody knows how to graph straight line. Well, first of all, let us graph original equation. We can use intercept method. X, Y. X equals 0. What we got, 3y equals 6, y equals 2. Y equals 0, x equals 3. So that's what we get, 0, 2, y intercept, and 3, 1, 2, 3, the same spaces. Most people don't do the same spaces. Some people give more space for action. Some people get different spaces for vertical and horizontal. This is our line, original line. Parallel line, we have y-intercept 11 over 3. It is almost 4, a little bit less. And the direction is the same. Now we can take 0.13 and it will be parallel line. And this will be perpendicular line, 3 over 2. 3 over 2, it is 1.5. This is 3 over 2, and this is our point. Well, it is approximately perpendicular. That's it. All three lines on the same graph. They pass through the point 1, 3. One is parallel, another is perpendicular. That's good. Many mistakes with graph. Wow. Oh no, where should it go? Okay, now I will clear. Number 4. Now we should find composition. One function is linear, another function is quadratic. This is fx, gx. Two x squared minus 4. And we need to find fg. G, F, G. What does it mean? F over G of X. What is it? How we calculate composition. Now we take f out of function, take x in parentheses. Like x in parentheses and replace x by g. We write 2x squared minus 4. Plus 3, and remove parentheses. 4 and combine like them, is 4x squared minus 8 plus 3. 4x squared minus 5. Okay, this is it. G of f. What is G of F? Only X and replace by F. Well, we use the formula, the square of sum. It's a square of first plus double product first and second plus square of second and multiply by two. We got 4 times 2, it will be 8x squared. Double product, 2 times 3, 6, 12, and 2 times 24x plus 9 times 2, 18, plus 18 minus 4. I will write the final answer, plus 14. That's it. Who can say what is f of f?
2.
Yes.
2 times 2x plus 3 plus 3.
Excellent. Very good. Very good. Plus 3. Very good. That's what we do. 4x plus 6 plus 3 equal 4x plus 9. Very good. Okay, and g of g. G of g. For x, we will write function 2x squared plus 4 squared minus 4. What we will get? We will get 4x to the 4 plus 8 times 2, 16x squared plus 16 and plus 32 minus 4. Not the same, we combine like them. So it will be negative. It will be plus 28. That's it. This is easy. Usually everybody do it perfect. No mistakes. It requires attention. Attention with science. That's it. Number 5, we need to find inverse. First, number 5, fx. Two x cubed minus 2. Gx. X minus 2. To find inverse, this is formal procedure. Y equal
2x plus 3.
Yes, first of all, we replace f by y, and then we change x and y. X equal to y
plus 3.
To y cube equal x plus 2 divide y cube equal and take cube root. And we can write this. So some people transform to clear off radical in denominator, we can multiply by cube root of 4.
That's 2.
And we will have 2.
Okay, x over 2.
And here we will get 4.
Minus 3 over 2.
So cube root 4x. 4x plus 2. Okay, That's the same. It is the same. But we can check whether it is really inverse function.
Why did you multiply by 4?
Because I want to clear off radical in denominator. I can rewrite it cube root x plus 2 over cube root over 2. And we know that usually we try to clear, it's not mandatory. If you write like this, it will be correct. But usually we try, don't have radical in denominator. Because we don't know how divide by cube root of 2. We can divide by 2. And how to clear? Multiply by cube root of 2 square. You will have cube root of 8. Cube root of 8, it is 2. It is 2. It is a real number. It is rational number. Rational number. 2. And here we multiply by cube root of 4. 4 under cube root. This is the same. This is equivalent. Because some people write final answer in such form or in this form. Both are correct. What happened if we substitute f for x? Now it is easier to take our first answer. 2x cubed minus 2 plus 2. 2x cubed divided by 2x cubed, and cube root of x cubed is x. We see f of f minus 1 equal x. And f minus 1 of f also will be the same, because when we substitute cube, we get x plus 2 over 2. 2 and 2 cancel, x plus 2 minus 2, x. So we can make sure that this is really inverse function. It's not mandatory. Okay, gx. Now use the same procedure, write y equal.
Y plus 1 over y plus 2.
X plus 1 over x minus 2. Okay, check, change x and y. Now solve for y, clear of denominator.
Y plus 2.
Now move terms with y here, y. X minus 1 equal 2x plus 1. That's it. So for y.
Not a g, not an f.
2x plus 1, yes, over x minus 1. And what we see for this function, if we try to graph vertical asymptote equal x equal 2, it is vertical asymptote, dashed line. Horizontal asymptote x equal 1. And we can draw this.
And vertical will be negative 2.
Negative 1 over 2. And this will be negative 1. This will be our, When we draw a asymptote, don't intersect and touch. Only show that this approach, but never go back from asymptote, only approach. Smooth curve, and this will be. That's how we do a symptote. We show that it approach, but never touch, never intersect, never overlap. That's what we do. Okay, this is a graph. You see, vertical asymptot equal x equal to vertical line. Horizontal asymptot y equal one, horizontal line. And what we can say about this function? Now, vertical asymptot will be x equal one. One on the same graph. This is vertical asymptot. And horizontal asymptot is two. You see, they change the places. Vertical became horizontal and horizontal became vertical. Mm-hmm. And intercepts also change plane. Now, y-intercept will be negative one as x-intercept. And this will be minus one over two. This will be. And approach to horizontal asymptot. Horizontal asymptot now is two. Vertical, this was two, now horizontal is two. Here, horizontal was one, now vertical is one. Where, no, X and Y change places. And we see that function are symmetrical with respect to line Y equal X. They intersect in the point y equal x. Y equal x is symmetry axis. That's very important to know when we will draw the graph of a rational function. We see that vertical asymptot of original function became horizontal of inverse. Horizontal and vertical change place. Y-intercept and x-intercept change places. And function symmetrical with respect to y equal x. That's it. Mm-hmm. This is correct. Number six, it is quadratic function. Number six, minus f x, negative two x square, plus eight x minus five. We know there are three ways we need to write in standard form. Standard form means that we should find the vertex. And to find the vertex, we should find symmetry axis. We can use completing the square, or we can use the formula for symmetry axis. Vertex, x vertex. Vertex is on symmetry axis, x vertex equal minus b over 2a equal minus 8 over minus 4. It will be plus 2. Plus 2. And to find y vertex, we simply substitute in equation. What we get? 2 squares 4 minus 8 plus 16, it is plus 8, and minus 4 it would be 3. That's it. So coordinate of vertex. Coordinate equal to 3. Symmetry axis is 2. And we need one more point to graph. It will be y-intercept. Y-intercept, we don't need to do any calculation. If we substitute x equals 0, we get constant term, minus 5. And symmetrical point will be at the same distance from 2. It will be 4 minus 5. 4 minus 5. We get negative 32 plus 4, 32, 0, negative 5. Symmetrical point. So we get 0, negative 5. And another point will be 4. Negative 5. But this, we can graph. Label same space, 1, 2, 3. Make symmetry axis as dashed line. X equal to 3. This is a vertex. Minus 5. It will be. And another point will be 4. That's it. 3 points is sufficient, but we will find another 2 points. We see that our graph intersects x-axis. So solve quadratic equation. Everybody know quadratic formula. Minus b plus minus square root b squared minus 4ac. Over 2a. Eight minus 8 plus minus square root of 64. Minus 40 divided by negative 4 equal to, now that 24, square root of 24, we can simplify. It will be 4 over 6. 4, square root of 4 is 2, we divide. 24 square root of 6 over 2. Well, we can find approximate value. Square root of 6, we take calculator. Square root of 6 equal 2. Approximately 245 over 2, it will be 122. 123. Here it will be this point. And here it will be 3, 6, 3, 27. it should be smooth curve, no acute angle, no lines, straight lines. No, approximately symmetrical. This point is positive four, negative five. That's what the graph. That's it. That's what we need. No, we see that this is maximum. We should answer all the question. The standard form will be negative two. Fx equal negative two x minus two square plus three. This is a step. If we remove parentheses, we will come to the same equation. That's it. Standard form, vertex. It is maximum because leading coefficient is negative, minus two. Y-intercept is negative five. It's constant term. And x-intercept are zeros. 2 plus minus square root of 6 over 2. That's it. Next will be parabola with vertex 3, 4 and passing through the point 1, 2, number 7. Vertex 3, 4 and point. We write standard form. The only unknown variable is a x minus 3 square plus 4. Now we substitute the coordinate of points. 2, it is y. Equal a 1 minus 3 square plus 4. It will be negative 2 square, it will be 4. 4a plus 4. And it will be 4a. Minus 2. A equal minus 1 over 2. And we can write the equation. Minus 1 over 2. X minus 3 square. Plus 4. Substitute the 4 point 1 minus 3, negative 2 square is positive 4. It will be minus 2 plus 4 equal 2. It passes through the points. That's it. This is easy. Usually everybody do it correct. Number eight, it is cubic equation. No, number eight, what it is? It is long division. Long division. 4x cubed minus 2x squared. Minus 7x plus 6 and divide by 2x plus 1. divide first by first. We get 2x squared multiply 4x cubed plus 2x squared. 2x square. Change sign because we subtract. Minus 4x square. Divide by 2x. It will be minus 2x. Minus 4x squared minus 2x. Plus cancel out plus minus 5x plus 6 divided by 2x, it will be plus minus 5 over 2, 2.5 minus 2.5. Just 8.5. This is a remainder. That's it. So we should be able to do both procedures, synthetic division and long division. It's like division of numbers, very similar. Number 9. It is cubic. Equation. Fx equal 4x, no, it will be 3x cubed plus 2x squared. Minus 19x plus 6. Well, there are different ways we can try to do factoring, but the most easy way is to synthetic division, because 1, 0 is given. It is given that x equal 2 is a 0. It means that x minus 2 is a factor. So we can do synthetic division, write coefficients without variables, 3, 2, minus 19, plus 6, and write 2. First is always the same, 3, because we divide by x minus 2. First coefficient is the same, 3. Then we multiply and add 3 times 2, 6, 8, 16, negative 3, negative 6, 0. That's what we get, because this is a factor, so remainder is 0. We can write the result is quadratic. 3x squared plus 8x minus 3. Well, we can find. Now we can solve quadratic equation. Can we do by factoring 3. Yes, we can factor this. Move first coefficient to the constant. We get x squared plus 8x minus 9 equals 0. And we will get minus plus 9 minus 1. X plus 9, x minus 1. The product is negative 9, the sum is 8. But now we need to divide each by 3. Each number divided by 3. And we get x plus 3. And here we get 3x minus 1. We can multiply and check that this is the same. 3x squared plus 9x minus x. That's correct. Now this is a factoring. And we can solve x equal negative 3 and x equal 1 over 3. That's now we have all zeros. It is negative 3, positive 1 over 3.
Professor, did you take attendance?
Attendance I take. I take attendance. What's your name?
Ilya.
Ah, you come late. Okay, okay, I mark it here. Okay,
thank you.
Only one student, Sarah. Sarah is not here. Okay. We are here. Oh, only one student person. Okay. Usually I take in the middle of session, but now I take earlier. But people come to be when I take attendance. It's not good. You should be here the whole session because we discuss logarithmic, exponential, important stuff. That's it. Now we find all three zeros. Now we can graph. And besides, what should we find? We should find behavior for large axes. Cubic function, leading coefficient is positive. So for negative numbers, we get negative function increasing more. I mark all zeros. A negative 3. 1, 2, 3. Minus 3. 1, 2, 3.
Professor, why do we have to graph it?
2, 3. Make the same spaces in all four directions. That's very important. And label axes, x, y. Behavior for large axes, as leading coefficient is positive, function increase from negative infinity to positive infinity. From negative infinity, it comes to first zero, to negative 3. Next will be 1 over 3 positive. It's very important to mark zeros correctly. 0, 1 over 3, and 2. And what is y-intercept? It is 6, 3, 4, 5, 6. Y-intercept should be taken correctly, 6. A little bit greater, 6. Then we come to 0. Then we come to set 0, and oh, that's what we need. Don't draw vertical lines. Sometimes slope is very large, but however, it shouldn't be exactly vertical. In my case, it's almost vertical.
Professor, the question didn't tell us to graph. So if on the test we don't graph, will we lose points?
No, here I say graph. Using synthetic division, given x equal, it is not written. No, in exam, using synthetic, no, but the assignment, right, using synthetic division, find all zeros and sketch the graph. You should sketch the graph. This is the sketch of the graph. Behavior for large axis, all three zeros, and y-intercept. That's four numbers should be shown on the graph, three zeros and y-intercept. Exactly, very often people don't find y-intercept on the right approximate. It should pass exactly through the point y equals 6, constant time. And on the from
Professor,
zero
to, I have a from,
yes, what is so your on question?
The, on the exam, you're gonna like state whether we need a graph or not, or just for every problem you have to make a graph.
For this number 9 and number 10, we need to graph. For number 6, yes, also we need to graph. Graph the parabola, the last example. Parabola and cubic function, we need to graph. And rational function, we also graph. That's it. And besides number 2, we also sketch the graph. The graphs are important. Some people do graphs not neatly. Don't write any numbers. Don't label axes. Don't make same spaces. You should write x, y on the axis. Show the lines if there are asymptotes, you should show them. Symmetry axis should be shown by dashed lines. We don't need many points. Some people calculate many, up to 10 points. We don't need it. And however, graph can be incorrect if you make mistake in arithmetic. You should take in account the properties. The properties, behavior for large axis, zeros, and intercept. And everything correspond to each other. From negative infinity, function come to first 0, negative 3. Then it come to positive 6, to y-intercept. And from 0 to 1 over 3, it changed from 6 to 0. We don't know the turning points. We don't know minimum, maximum. We don't know derivative yet. We only show turning point, two turning points. And the last is positive 2 that is given. And then it increase to up to positive infinity. That's it. Next will be number 10, again cubic. Now leading coefficient is negative, pay attention. So behavior for large axis should be opposite, different. Number 10. FX.
Professor, I have a follow-up question. The exam on Thursday will start at the class time, right?
Yeah, we should, everybody should come to the class. I will take attendance. And but usually I give more time. You can send me email up to 3 o'clock. 6 hours is given.
All right, and where will the exam be?
Exam will be on Canvas the same day from 9 on Thursday.
On so it'll Thursday, be
a... July 14, 9 a.m.
So it'll be uploaded in the morning on Thursday. Perfect. Thank
yes,
you.
Yes, yes. Everybody should come to class. Then you can leave. You can leave earlier. If you do earlier, you can send your mail and leave. Now what we do? Again, what is given? Now we need, nothing is given. But we can check. We know that the factor of constant term or the ratio of constant term to leading coefficient may be the ratio, as all coefficients are whole numbers, rational zeros are factors of constant term. Now we can see that 1 is a 0, x equal 1. Now if we substitute 1, we will get negative 7 plus 7, 0. That's it. So x equal 1 is the 0. So we can do synthetic division. The same thing we can write. Minus 2, minus 5, plus 4, plus 3. Positive 1. Minus 2. Okay, now we write quadratic equation. Minus 2x squared minus 7x minus 3 equals 0. Now we can solve it. We can write positive coefficients. Zeros will be the same. Again, we can solve by factoring. Rational solution. Here it will be x plus 6, x plus 1, and divide by 2, by 2. It will be x plus 3, and here we get 2x plus 1. We write without denominator. We can check. If we multiply, we will get equation. Okay, 2x squared plus 7x. That's it. Now we see that we have two solutions. X equal negative 3. X equal negative 3. X equal negative 1. No, equal negative 1 over 2. And 1. So, zeros, negative 3, negative 1 over 2, positive 1. And y-intercept equals 3. That's what we need. Now, behavior for large axes will be opposite. It is decreasing. For negative, it will be positive. For positive, it will be negative, because leading coefficient is negative. Now mark zeros. 1, 2, 3, -3, -1. It's very important to give correct signs, because some people draw this as positive. It is negative, -1/2. And 1. -3. That's it. This is a sketch of graph. We need 3 zeros and we need y-intercept. That's it. And behavior for large axes. Так что я видела. That's it. Now complex numbers. It is easy. We know how to do it. We multiply by conjugate. Divide.
-3 + 4i. That adds up to 6 + 17i.
Mm-hmm.
Over 9
plus
17i.
8i plus 9i and plus 12i square, it will be -6. Mm-hmm. -6. We replace I square by -1 plus 17i. And what we have in the denominator, we have 9 minus 16 I square, it will be plus 16, it will be 25. That's it, we cannot simplify this. Exactly. Number 12, rational function. Most mistakes are in this. I don't know why, but many people do it wrong. Fx. 2x plus 3. X minus 1. Well, first of all, domain. What is domain?
X cannot be 1.
Okay. And so we can write vertical asymptote equal x equal 1. Then we find range. No, range not equal 2. Because the limit, the both linear function, the limit is the ratio of leading coefficient, 2, not equal 2, so horizontal asymptote y equal 2. x, y. Make same spaces. That's it. Now we make vertical ascent, x equal one. Dashed line. Show this by dashed line. Y equal two, horizontal ascent. Also show both asymptotes should be shown on the graph. Because when you don't graph asymptote, very often your graph overlap. It should be one branch on one side of vertical asymptote, another branch on the other side. They cannot overlap. Mm-hmm. Now we find what is y-intercept equal negative three. And x-intercept equal negative three over two. That's it. This will be negative branch. All values in this interval are negative because our function, rational function, change sign only at asymptotes and zeros. Here it is negative. It is negative on the whole interval from asymptote to. Now it change sign to positive. And approach to horizontal asymptote. Don't intersect. Don't remove from it. It should only approach, show that it approach, but don't touch or intersect. And that's it. Here we don't have points, but here we see that it is positive for large x. X greater than one, numerator and denominator positive. That's it. Function approach to, if we approach to one from the right, function approach to positive infinity. And here it jumped from positive infinity to negative infinity. Here for large x, it approach to horizontal. That's it, that's it. This is the graph. So two lines should be shown, vertical asymptote, x equal one, horizontal asymptote, y equal two. And two points, x-intercept and y-intercept. This is negative three, minus three. And this is minus three over two. Two points should be shown on the graph. That's it. Now that's what we did today. Exponential function. Number 13. 3 over 2x. Equal 1 over 81. Well, we can transform to the same base. It's 3 and base is negative, minus 4, because negative means 1 over 3. 3 to the 4 is 81. So base is the same, expression is the same. We can write 2x equal negative 4. X equal negative 2. That's it. Next. X minus 4 over 3. Equal 1 over 16. Now we should make exponent equal 1. How can we do it? We can multiply by reciprocal. Reciprocal will be 3, negative 3 over 4. Negative 4 over 3. Negative 3 over 4. The product equal 1. 1 over 16. Erase into same exponent. Negative 3 over 4. Both sides. Here we get x. Here we get 1 over 16. Now, first of all, change negative exponent to positive. It will be 16, 3 over 4. Some people erase into third power first, large numbers, and take 4. No, it's easier to take fourth root. What is 3 over 4? It is fourth root of 16 cube. But fourth root of 16 is 2. 2 cube is 8. That's it. This is answer. X equals
8. And it was 8.
Yes. Now we need number 14. We solve logarithmic equation. Log. No base means that base is 10. X minus 9 plus log x equal 1. Now we condense log x minus 9 times x equal 1. And we can write x times x minus 9 equal 10, because base is 10. 10 to the 1 is 10. And we write equation x squared minus 9x minus 10 equals 0. And we can factor. It will be x minus 10, x plus 1. Mm-hmm. Now will be x equal 10 and x equal negative 1. As it is logarithmic equation, x minus 1 is not solution because it is not in domain. Minus 1 is undefined. But 10 is good because 10 minus 9 is 1, log 1 is 0, and log 10 is 1. That's correct. Log 10 equal 1. The original equation is satisfied. That's it. Now the last equation. Number 15. Log 2. Plus log 2 x plus 3 plus or minus x plus 6 equal 1. First of all, condense x plus 3 over x plus 6. Yes, equal 1. So we can write x squared plus 3x over x plus 6 equal 2. Mm-hmm. 2 to the 1. 2 to the 1 is 2. And we get x squared plus 3x equal 2x plus 12. And we get x squared plus x minus 12 equals 0. It can be factored. X plus 4, x minus 3. Uh-huh. And we get x negative 4 and x equals 3, which is in domain. No, negative 4 is not in domain.
X equals 3.
X equals 3 is good. Uh-huh. Because here we get 2, 3 plus 6. Uh-huh. 3 times 6, it is 18, divided by 9. 3 plus 6 is 9, divided by 9 is 2. Log 2, 2 is 1. That's correct. We can substitute an original equation and we get true. That's it. Exactly. Now we exactly finish in time. Any questions?
No, thank you, Professor.
Okay. Yes, start class. Then I just get to the conclusion. So that's it. No questions, that's good. So I hope everybody will come. Midterm is very important. We don't do makeup, but it makes sense to take midterm is easier because it's only half. And final test will be cumulative. All this material will be also repeated in final. But in
Professor.
Yes.
I sent you an email about Thursday.
Yes, Thursday and Thursday up to 3 p.m.
Up to okay. 3.
Yes. You should come to class. I will take attendance. No. It's better to be in class, to keep your name. You can be whatever you want. We don't check where you are and what you do. We don't check you. But it's better to keep your name in the system up to 12:20, up to the end. And then you can leave and you can. You should send email. Use simple, so make it legible. Write hard. Some homeworks is very difficult to read. Some people use light ink, like dark ink, black or blue, dark blue. Dark and press harder and don't write too small, write larger. Make it easier to read. That's it.
I'm gonna get some graph paper to make it easier on you.
Graph paper is good, but some people they even make them not the same space even using graph paper. They don't draw a line along the lines on paper. The coordinate axis should follow the lines of the paper. Doesn't matter, graph paper, you can use usual, but same spaces. It makes sense to take, for example, if you have lines, you mm-hmm. have two spaces, divide the distance between lines by two and keep the same for horizontal direction also. Graph paper is good, but it's a little bit neatly, more neatly.
Yes. All right, Professor, thank you so much. And I'll see you next
you're
time.
Welcome. You're welcome. See you. I hope everybody will come.
Right. On, Professor, how many questions are on the midterm?
I know you need a secret. I don't agree. I don't need to do this. Yes, I do this.
Caitlin?
Yes, I do this. Yes, I do this. Yes, I do this. Yes, I do this. Yes, I do this.
Yes, I do this. Who is it? Is it a child? It's some student or it is somebody in child's kids.
How many questions are on the test, on the exam?
In general, it will be the same. 15. Okay. The same.
15?
Mm-hmm. 15? 50, yes. 15. Some questions include more than one questions, two questions. It will be approximately the same as review. What I advise you to do at home, don't look in your notes. Try to do everything independently. Do at your own, and then compare the answers. You can read, your notes, then put away your notes and do all problems at your own independently. If you will be able to do review, you will have no problems with the test, because the problems will be similar. Only numbers will be different, but the topics, the ideas will be the same.
Okay, thank you so much, Professor. See you Thursday.
Okay, see you on Thursday. Bye. Ну, так точно, кому мы уложили.
А что это 12:22? Точно. 12:20, так у нас...